Mic check. 1, 2, 1, 2. Are y'all ready?
Hey everyone! Oh, it's so great to see you guys here at Kids Church again. It's great to see you. Let's see. Oh, hey Maggie. Hey Susanna. Hi Gracie. Hi Peter. Hi Seth. Oh, you guys are awesome. So all this summer, we have been talking about what it means to have confidence. Confidence is just seeing yourself the way that God sees you. That's where true confidence comes from, is when you know how much God loves you and that He is always, always with you. So, you know, this song that we've been listening to makes me feel really confident. Whenever I'm having a really hard day, like, all I want to do is, like, crank up this song and I instantly feel like I can take on the world. You guys have a song like that? I call it my walk-up song. You guys know what that is? Like in baseball, right? Like when a new player is coming up to bat, they play a song that they've chosen that really like pumps them up, right? Or maybe a basketball player has a really cool song playing while they're warming up, like before the game, right? So it's like that. It's a song that always pumps you up. That's what a walk-up song is. So I put together a playlist of some really great, high-energy walk-up songs that's going to really make us move, okay? And it'll come really in handy right now because we're going to play a game called the Tissue Dance-Off. All right, so here's what you need to do. Pause this video. Go get a tissue. And then what you're going to do is put it on top of your head like this. So when the music plays, everyone has to dance. And I mean, you really have to dance, not just like, okay, where you're not really moving, okay? You gotta dance, oh! Okay, and now the point is to, while you dance, try to keep the tissue on your head. If it falls off, you gotta stop and you gotta sit down until the next song comes on, right? So you don't have to worry, like I said, you can pop right back up once we switch songs and try it again. But try and keep that tissue on your head as long as possible while you're really, really dancing. You think you can do it? It's gonna be kind of hard. You guys ready? All right, here we go. Let's play the first song. Everybody dance now.
Everybody dance now.
Turn down for what?
All right, that was fun. Okay, it was a really good dance off. And you know what? It's kind of confidence boosting, right? When you hear all those songs. But go ahead and throw that tissue away. I'm glad you guys had fun. You know what? That is something that you guys can do kind of anytime, is you can have a tissue dance off at your house. Just put on some great tunes. Crank them up, put that tissue, and see how long you can dance without that tissue falling off your head. Silly, but good. Okay. Who remembers our memory verse for this month? Anybody? It is from Philippians, and it's chapter 1, verse 6. It goes like this. Being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. So the guy who wrote our memory verse is a guy named Paul. He was writing that letter to the church in Philippi, the Philippians. And at first, Paul was trying to stop people from believing in Jesus. But one day, Paul had an experience with Jesus that changed his life forever. Paul began to travel all over to tell people the good news about Jesus. And this often meant he kind of ended up in some trouble, like with some religious leaders and government officials. So let's see what else happened to Paul. One thing that happened in his life. Bible story time.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. the epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Ephesians, chapter 6, verses 10 through 17.
The Apostle Paul spent his last 2 years as a prisoner in Rome. But even though he wasn't free to travel, he shared God's truth with everyone who visited and often wrote strong letters to the churches he had started. One of those letters went to the believers at the church in Ephesus.
Finally, let the Lord make you strong. Depend on his mighty power. Put on all of God's armor. Then you can remain strong against the devil's evil plans.
Now, armor isn't something we see every day. Maybe you think of this. Or this. But remember, Paul wrote this letter when he was in prison. In the book of Acts, his friend Luke explains,
"When we got to Rome, Paul was allowed to live by himself, but a soldier guarded him."
This means that Paul was guarded by at least one Roman soldier every single hour of the day. In fact, Paul was probably even chained to that soldier.
So every day, Paul had a great opportunity to study this armor in real detail. He knew that when dressed up in armor, a Roman soldier could withstand any attack by an enemy. Paul also knew that the main enemy we face isn't one we can see.
Our fight is not against human beings. It is against the rulers, the authorities, and the powers of this dark world. It is against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly world. So put on all of God's armor. Evil days will come. But you will be able to stand up to anything. And after you have done everything you can, you will still be standing.
See, our fight is not with human beings. Paul reminds us that the real enemy is spiritual forces of evil. Now, that might sound really weird and creepy, but it's actually very simple. God has an enemy called Satan. Now, we know at the end Satan is defeated, but right now Satan is trying to mess with what God loves most. People. We're fighting a battle with an enemy we can't see. And because of this, Paul says, we need a very special kind of armor.
So remain strong in the faith. Put the belt of truth around your waist.
A belt tied up loose clothing and held weapons, so a soldier was all ready to go.
God wants us to prepare ourselves with the truth that he loves us and is always with us, and that he'll give us the wisdom to face any tough decision we have to make.
Put the armor of godliness on your chest.
This piece, sometimes called a breastplate, protected a soldier's heart and lungs and stomach. You know, all the important stuff.
Paul says our protection is godliness. That means simply following God in what we do and say by loving God and loving others. It's our best defense against the enemy.
Wear on your feet what will prepare you to tell the good news of peace.
Check these out. Kind of sandals, kind of cleats. Roman soldiers actually wore shoes with nails sticking out of the bottom so they could get a good grip on rough and rocky roads.
Paul says the way we can get a grip is to share the message of God's peace with everybody we meet, wherever our feet will take us. Thanks to Jesus, everyone can have peace with God.
Also, pick up the shield of faith. With it, you can put out all the flaming arrows of the evil one.
Rejected! A Roman soldier's shield was everything. Not only could a soldier block arrows and swords and spears, but he could get right behind this and charge, pushing back the enemy.
And that's exactly what strong faith in God and his promises can do for us. Maybe the enemy tries to sneak in with the thought that God doesn't love me. But you can block that right away because you know that nothing can separate you from God's love. He promises that. Or maybe you're struck with a wave of doubt that you can't make a hard choice. But you can block that when you remember that God promises to guide your steps when you trust him.
Put on the helmet of salvation.
A helmet protects just what you think, your head and mind.
The enemy likes to sneak attack with small lies and spiraling thoughts of negativity. But if you put on the helmet of salvation, trusting in God and following Jesus, that'll protect your mind.
And take the sword of the Holy Spirit. The sword is God's word.
When the enemy attacks, Paul says we have a way to fight back. Our weapon is the sword of God's word. Jesus himself used God's words from Scripture when he was tempted by Satan. As Paul says,
"Put on all of God's armor. Evil days will come, but you will be able to stand up to anything. And after you have done everything you can, you will still be standing."
When you discover God's words written down in the Bible and hold them in your head and your heart, you can stand up to any attack by the enemy.
You guys remember, Paul said to put on God's armor, all of it. Put on the belt of truth and the armor of godliness on your chest, and the good news of patience on your feet, and the shield of faith and the helmet of salvation, and to carry the sword of the Holy Spirit, which is the word of God. All of those things, the full armor. Now, truly, like, we're not going to be actually putting on armor like an old knight or something, right? But think about each one of those things. God has given us absolutely everything that we need to stand up to anything that we face in our life because of our confidence in Him. Use what God has given you to stand strong. All of those things that He's given us. Now let's talk to God right now, you guys, and ask Him to help us do just that. Will you pray with me? Dear God, thank you for giving us all we need to stand strong. Help us be strong in what we believe by putting on the belt of truth, the armor of godliness, and the good news of peace on our feet. Help us to put on the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Holy Spirit, the sword of your word. Help us remember how much you love us and all that you have done for us so that we can live with true confidence every day. We love you and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. So the truth is, you guys, we're going to have trouble in this world, right? We've talked about that. We're going to get in arguments with our friends and family members maybe, and things are going to happen that we never expect. People are going to get sick. People are going to die. But God has given us the armor that will help us be ready for troubles that we can't see, that we don't know are coming. His armor will protect us and help us stand strong. So use what God has given you to stand strong. Will you say that with me? That's our bottom line. Our bottom line. I really want you to remember it. Use what God has given you to stand strong. Paul wrote that God's word is like a sword, and when the voices inside you try to tell you that you're not good enough or that you don't matter, your sword can help you fight back with the truth of what God says about you, right? That means that you do matter. God loves you so much, He sent Jesus to save you from your sins. That's the truth that can give you confidence. Always remember that God is with you and you can trust Him no matter what. That armor of God that He gives you is going to help you stand strong through absolutely anything that you face in life. Okay, you guys, why don't you download the small group activities, okay, from the description, from this video, and you'll get to talk more about what it means to put on that armor of God so that you can stand strong. Now, for the question of the week. Right, so talk about that, you guys, with your friends and your family. And I love ya, and I'll see you soon.
Mic check. 1, 2, 1, 2. Are y'all ready?
To replace Seven Nation Army by White Stripe.
Seven Nation Army by the White Stripes now playing. dance now. Bussy and C Music Factory now playing.